Hi, everybody. We're here at Devoxx 2014, and I'm here with Martin.
Hello.
Martin. And Martin has an interesting session here at the conference, which is called something like, nobody does MapReduce anymore at Google. So Google kind of invented MapReduce, and now you tell us, just a few years later, when everybody is using it and various implementation, that you know this was a bad idea, in fact, right?
Well, the MapReduce paper was published in 2004. That's 10 years ago. You can imagine that the train has been moving since then. But actually, yes, the title of the talk is a little bit provocative. There is still a lot of MapReduce going on. The reality is that it would be, I think, a bad idea to launch a MapReduce as a service today, because what we are using in-house is much more powerful than that. And that's actually what we will be releasing shortly. It's called Google Cloud Dataflow.
So Dataflow. So this is based on another paper, which I believe is called Flume Java.
Yes, exactly.
And it's a higher level of abstraction. So maybe MapReduce is just one way to implement whatever you express in Dataflow. So walk us through what Dataflow is, maybe for the developer. It's about dealing with data, right?
Exactly. What you want to do is crunch huge amounts of data. And when you do this for a living, you realize that even for small problems, one MapReduce stage is usually not enough. You want to have at least two of them, or maybe five of them
in
a different graph. Not just a pipeline, it could be a graph.
A graph,
Two MapReduces, merging the results, going into a third one, and then doing something else with the data again. And this, if you try to implement it using MapReduce, you end up with a lot of plumbing, because you need to handle all those intermediate results, you need to actually deploy your MapReduce clusters and all that. So there is a better way. And the way we are suggesting to developers to do it today is to use a very small number of high-level primitives in Java, for example, and define the computation using those primitives. Those primitives work on parallel collections and are executed lazily, which means that the code you write is simply used by the system to infer an execution graph in memory. Once we have that graph, we can optimize it, and we can deploy the optimal cluster topology for actually running your computation. Deploy it, run it, tear it down. Of course, you still get all the benefits of MapReduce, which means it's a parallel execution framework. The life cycle of the nodes is handled for you. The catastrophic events, like a node dying unexpectedly or not responding, that's handled for you. You really only focus on the math, the computation you want to do on your data.
So walk us through briefly what the API looks like as a developer. How do I develop and use this? What is my input, output, operations? What does the API look like?
So the basic piece of data you act on is a P collection. That's a parallel connect collection. It's an immutable collection of data. And then you use primitives to work on it. The most basic primitive is parallel do. A parallel operation, a function you provide, that's the equivalent of map or reduce in the MapReduce paradigm. The second important primitive is a group by key. So normally when you do a parallel do, you do computations on your data and you also assign keys to your data. So the output is key value pairs. And then again in the MapReduce paradigm, you have a group by key, which is called a shuffle stage, which will put all the data with the same key together and apply another, usually an aggregation on those data. Uh-huh. So parallel collections, parallel do, group by key, and then a third primitive, which is an associative parallel do. There is a lot of good stuff that can happen when your parallel do is associative. So with those three primitives, it's enough to describe most of the computations you want to do. And then Flume Java also adds functions, helper functions, which are already implemented on top of those, like counting or a join or a top operation.
Okay, So this is you mentioned Flume Java. That's the paper that was published around 2010, I think.
Yes.
It's based on experience Google has running this type of technology in production. But what we're offering here is a product called Dataflow, and that's a service we're offering because you want to focus as a developer on that level of API you just described and leave to Google everything else, which is setting up the environment, the network, the nodes, and spinning up the resources and in the most efficient and fastest way to provide a result back.
Exactly. And the beauty of it is that if you have a complex computation, which actually results in a fairly complex network topology for your processing cluster, if there is something you need to change, it's a couple of lines in your code. And you hit enter, and that cluster gets redeployed with a different topology. That's really how you want to manage a compute cluster. You don't want to be there changing the nodes and rewiring them because you need to compute something slightly differently.
Yeah. So the other thing is the data you work on. This is like read-only data. You have a batch of data, or can you have some sort of streaming, or is there anything?
Well, that's the second, I would say, magic strong point of Dataflow is that once you have your computation described in using the high-level primitives, to turn this into a streaming computation, what you do is that you change your inputs and outputs. Instead of reading from a file, you read from a stream.
Okay.
You add one line of code, which is, please now work with this time window. And that's it. This cluster becomes a real-time data processing cluster that does everything the batch processing cluster was doing. So still node life cycle, nodes dying and all that, all this is handled for you.
Uh-huh.
But now it can also automatically scale with the volume of data. And if you think about it, inside it uses parallel sets of nodes for executing your parallel dues. It can figure out how many nodes to put in parallel to actually sustain the flow. And those parallel processing groups of nodes, they are actually put together in a complex execution graph, but you don't have to worry about that. There is an optimizer that worries about that, and there is an executor that worries about putting the whole thing on autopilot.
I like about all those things I don't have to worry about. So when can folks start using this? This is Dataflow, that's a service, a product Google Cloud is offering soon?
So we've been using it for many years at Google, which means that it's not a completely non-baked technology. In the session today, you will see a live demo.
Okay.
So that's the status.
So yeah, that's a good plug for your session for people to watch this on Parlays as soon as it's published.
Indeed.
So Martin, I think that's all the time we have for. So thanks for doing this and good luck with the session. And folks, keep an eye on Cloud Dataflow.
Thank you,
everyone.